Hey everybody, my name's Leland with Friends of Salons, and welcome back to another episode of the FOSJ Video Shorts. Tips and tricks for backcountry travel in the San Juan Mountains. Today, we're joined by Jack Lim from San Juan Expeditions, who's gonna talk a little bit about backcountry etiquette. Everybody's out here trying to enjoy the backcountry. Here's a few tips and tricks to be considerate of other users while we're out traveling in the mountains.
What's up, everybody? My name is Jack Klim with San Juan Expeditions, and today we're going to be talking about considerations for setting a skin track, using radios, and choosing locations for snow pits. So when I'm out in the backcountry, I find using radios is really important for communicating to my team when we're skiing on slope, or if we have other folks in the area to communicate observations and any test results we might be finding to share that information. While we're on the radio, let's try to keep it brief. Keep chatter to a minimum. Let's be very succinct with what we're doing or what we're saying and communicate with a closed loop, meaning if I'm calling someone, I want them to call back to me and close that loop. Jack to Leland, dropping in 10 seconds. When setting a skin track, there's a lot of things to take into account. And first and foremost with that, it needs to be, number one, safe. Number two, your skin track needs to be efficient, or the path of least resistance. And number three, it needs to be accurate, or in the direction of your objective. So we just finished ripping some turns down over here on this face, and we're now setting a skin track in this lower angle terrain off in the trees. We're not gonna set the skin track back up that face for safety reasons, other people skiing down, as well as minimizing your exposure, and then also to preserve fresh snow for the rest of the day. So when we come across another skin track that we're gonna use, try preserving it on your split board or on your skis. If you're snowshoeing or recreationally post-holing, try to step to the side and use another track. That's the best practice. And if you need to use the bathroom, take a step off the skin track. When you're out in the backcountry and you see another group, take it as an opportunity to share some information about what you're seeing around with the avalanche conditions and spread the stoke. Sup, dude?
Hey, man.
How are you, man?
Good, dude.
Good.
What's going on out here?
Other things to consider when we're digging our pit location is making sure that it's safe, as well as it's polite. So that means just not digging the pit in the middle of a slope or at the bottom of a slope for someone to ski in.
Whoa! Oh!
As well as when we're finished with our pit, we're gonna backfill it in. And folks like to say, don't be a troll, fill in your hole.
Thanks for showing up, Jack, and for providing the backcountry community with some recommendations to consider when we're out traveling in the mountains. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you next time.